TV0039 here, just checking it out. This down here is Chaska, Shakopee Province. It was Highway 41, the one that flooded out here recently. I'm on 169 South. Heading down to Jordan on my way to Gaylord. We're just having a little road trip. Lots of neat scenery around here. Yeah, there's a nice little greenhouse there. The quarry. Brick company. More scenery. Minnesota's notorious for it. Lots and lots of traffic today. Pretty beautiful out though today. Even though it's kind of over crappy and cloudy, kind of cruddy out, it isn't too bad a day. Them pretty menacing clouds. Something they screwed up for more scenery. They put up a fucking landfill here, which, you know, innately pissed me off. And during the summer, man, it fucking stinks right along here. And that's enough to piss you off. Here's another nursery I go to quite frequently during the summer and get stuff for. It's a neat nursery. There's also a big tree farm here where they grow all kinds of trees. They grow them on both sides of the freeways, but the ones you can tell is a nursery is on this side of the freeway. They're a pretty neat company. Did some forklift work for them when I worked for a Home Depot. We used to come out here and get the trees from these guys long, long time ago. But yeah, and pick up trees and bring them into the Home Depot where you could purchase them, or you could purchase them from a catalog and then come out here and have them picked. Pick the one you want. It's pretty cool. Big old tree farm here. All different kinds of trees, and they're starting to bloom and sprout now, so it's that time of the year. And over here they got their little spruce farm, spruce field. Here, over here we got the big glass factory. And next to it we got the block and rock place. Over here we got another small quarry, and this one's designed for doing aggregate for concrete. A little bit of farmland, and looks like that'll be getting turned into quarry. They're just eating up all the frickin' resources around here as fast as they frickin' can. And they destroy the frickin' land, and that just drives me ape shit. Because they don't replace it or don't repair it or don't put it back to its condition. They just sell it off. so someone else makes it bigger and worse, which is something that's been pretty notoriously done around here. This is one of my favorite little scenes here at the Bluff, because this freeway is along the river bottoms. The Bluff is real pretty. Jordan, Minnesota. Most of the towns aren't too far from each other, usually within about anywhere between a 5 and 30 minute jaunt, you know, away, so it's not too bad. Once you get further southern Minnesota, it's more sporadic, and then you get northern Minnesota, it's more sporadic as well. It's not as, they're not as close, but, here's the Jordan trailer park that no one would mind if it flooded out, except the people living there, but can't say from experience that I, really give too much of a shit, because, I didn't meet too many good people down there. Not saying there isn't any. But this is Jordan, pretty much. There ain't much to it. Pretty dinky little town. There's a few thousand people in it. Not really a lot to shake a stick at, but it goes back further south, or further east, along the bluffs and hills. Over here, once you start heading out towards this way, you're looking at out towards the state fairgrounds and or county fairgrounds and different places. Traffic sucks today. Kind of a quiet quiet little place. A few months back, I was out and on my way down to pick up my daughter, and I saw some pretty interesting stuff in the sky. I couldn't explain. I wish I would have had my camera that day. But it was in this area, and it was right in the sky above here. There was something that, it was a clear day, it was blue sky, and it zipped completely across the whole, you know, camera frame, right across the whole windshield. It like started where that Crumbie sign is in the sky about, and then it just zipped across and stopped. And then from there, it went straight up. It was just, it was completely weird. The weirdest, one of the weirdest things I've ever saw. And hopefully, you know, I catch another one of them things out here on video, because I really think it would be pretty cool to catch that on video and show you guys. Yeah, this is a pretty beautiful chunk of scenery. It really is. This trip going south, we're heading south on 169, so you're going to see a lot of really beautiful scenery. It is, it's just gorgeous. couldn't ask for much much more beautiful. This pretty cool place up here on your left, it's the light colored building is a horse ranch or cattle or stable. Horse stable. And they do horse training and horse teaching to the public. And they do farm rides and, you know, and country rides and cruises and teach kids how to ride horses. And the place next to it is a restaurant called OK Corral, and it's got real good food. One of my favorite places, and my other favorite place, Suzette's. Now, my little brother used to work at that little restaurant, and I recommend eating there any day of the week. Some of the best Italian and French cuisine there is around here. And it's out in the frickin' country, you know, believe it or not, but it is. It's a really great place. This place right here, the Apple Barn, I've been going to it for years with my kids. Awesome place to get apples and whatnot. It is a really good place to get all kinds of good organic healthy stuff. Oh, and sweets, pies, and different fruit sweets, and it's just a great place for kids and families. Out here is some really cool scenery. Lots of traffic today. Lots of really cool scenery today. We are road tripping it, folks. And now we are on our way to Belle Plaine. Be heading through Belle Plaine a little bit. I'm gonna be late to get my daughter today because of traffic. It's pretty crappy getting out of the cities. It took me 35 minutes just to get out of the cities. And normally it doesn't take me more than, you know, 10. There was so much frickin' traffic, it took forever. Probably shouldn't be speeding through here. This is just beautiful country out here. Couldn't ask for cooler country. Just beautiful out here as far as the scenery goes. Out here, everything's starting to come up and get green. You've got to slow down through Belle Plaine. The cops in this town are horrible. Man, they pull you over for opening your window after passing gas. I mean, it's ridiculous. Yeah, Jordan cops I never had a problem with. They're pretty laid back people. They don't bother you for stupid shit. But Belle Plaine cops, they've had a lot of problem with drugs and juvenile delinquency and different problems in this town here. And it doesn't really help that there's 8 or 9 bars in town. In a town of 3 or 4,000 people, you know, when you got 8 or 9 bars, that kind of breeds alcoholism. So you can expect it to be, I don't know, a problem. I grew up in this town a little bit. I know quite a bit about it. I don't care much for it as far as the social structure goes around here. But it's quite egomaniacal and redneck, if you ask me. But hey, each to their own. I know quite a few people from this town. There's a few that I still love and care about, and And trust me, there's quite a few I absolutely would like to forget about. You know, they got a lot of freaking graveyards in this town too. They got like 12 or 13 graveyards. It's ridiculous. It's like the people die by the handfuls around here. From what, I don't know, but it's a pretty cool park. It's got a big old helicopter in it. Emma Crumbie's, yes. One of my favorite places to eat. It's a very good place to eat. Awesome food. You can't find much better other than Suzette's. I will beg to differ. Suzette's is better. It's more traditional and more authentic. Yeah, I like the fact that you can, you know, there's all kinds of different chunks of life out here. I mean, it's definitely a trip. Now, we'll be on our way to Henderson. And it's going to be a few more minutes. It's actually a little farther to Henderson, you know, from Belle Plaine than it is from Jordan Shakopee and Belle Plaine. They're pretty close to each other. You know, they're within, you know, 7 miles of each other. So, you know, 7 to 15 miles of each other, so that ain't that far, but Henderson's a good chunk away. It's one of my favorite valleys. I used to ride my bike up this hill so I could go down there and then go down along the river bottoms, but this has always been a really nice view up here and really nice scenery. And it's a kind of a gradual hill, so it's not so hard to ride your bike up, but it's not some big, steep, retarded, you know, gradient. I know this area pretty good, well, pretty much like the back of my hand. I used to run these fields and these groves and when I was a little kid. There's one of them right there I used to run around in and play in. I'm surprised I never got frickin' Lyme disease. All the fucking ticks around here. It is a beautiful country. I mean, as far as the eye can see, it's just gorgeous out here. There's all kinds of farms, and everybody's growing something different or raising something. There's always all kinds of different animals you see. This has always been one of my favorite properties just because of the trees. Guy got lucky. He's got a whole frickin' property full of oak trees. They're just beautiful. And they got a few cows out here. It's pretty cool around here. I love this state, man. You can't ask for any better scenery. The weather's always changing. It's never the same. This little town here, Blakely, we'll end up going through it one of these days. Depending on the way back, it might not be flooded anymore, so we should go check it out. Because that's where I did the Blakely and Henderson flooding videos. We could go check it out to see if it's flooded, and I bet it's not anymore. So that'll be pretty cool. This house right here is just sitting right there. Great big old farmhouse and property. It's just sitting there. I don't know, I just liked it. Always liked it. Along the freeway here, when you get further south down by Le Sueur, Minnesota, there's a couple historical homes that have been around here for a couple of hundred years. And it's pretty neat to go in and check them out. And I've always enjoyed the going to see the historical buildings they've remodeled and you know, back to the days that they were pertinent. And you get out here and it's just all fields and groves and couldn't ask for anything cooler. And we're almost to Henderson, Minnesota, which won't take us long. Oh, and another graveyard. Imagine that. Hell, just driving through Blau Plain, we've seen 3 graveyards. That's, you know, the odds of you driving into a town and seeing 3 graveyards right away off the freeway kind of says something to you. It's kind of creepy. Yeah. But anyway, we can take this little exit that we're going to take. It brings us from New Prague. There are 2 New Prague and Gaylord. New Prague is out east of here, and we're going west of it. This is where you're going to see some real country, folks. And I do mean some real country. It is as country as hell out here. And that's what I love about this place, because, you know, I got property out here, and it's nice and quiet. It's beautiful river property, river valley property. So it's you can't get any more beautiful. And I mean, look at this out here. Tell me that is not a great big beautiful picture of scenery. You know what I mean? It's just gorgeous. And the river valley you're about to go down and see is well, that's a pretty nifty one. I've always liked this road because it gives you such a perspective coming down it that, you know, it's like no other. You know, it's like when you walk up on the Grand Canyon for the first time. It's just a beauty. And in the spring, it's just beautiful. All the trees are blooming and the grasses and flowers and whatnot. And there's a couple of these roads out here where the county still plants all the wild grasses. So I'm going to zoom up here a little bit. So you can get a little better picture here. Yeah, this is really cool here, through here. There's a neat little farm right here. Got a nice creek going through it. And here is the big hill. I mean, and it's not a little hill, folks. We're talking about an extremely large hill. And here we go. It overlooks, you know, a good 500 foot drop off over the river. I don't know how well you can see out there, but we're talking about, it's a great big frickin' hill. It's nothing to fart around with. And it overlooks the river, the river valley. There isn't too much of a part in the trees to see because the trees are so dense through here. But yeah, it's a great big frickin' valley. It's nothing to shake a stick at. And my favorite little town in the whole of America. There is no other town that is cooler. There is no other town that is neater. There is no other town that's cool and historical as this little one. Henderson, Minnesota. This road is all flooded out. As you can see, there's still water along the edge of the road here. And this is, you know, it's kind of like the mangrove jungles in, you know, South America. It's pretty dense. Pretty dense river valley here. This is my favorite little town, Henderson, Minnesota. Yeah, look at all this, you know, all the from the river, all the sandbars and stuff. And this sucker overflowed big time. It's still up there. It's still really up there. It's still over the banks a little bit in a lot of places. Yeah, Minnesota River. And Henderson, Minnesota. And this is it. Wow. Look at the bustling population and density. No, it's quiet, and the people are so nice. I've never met nicer people. And they have a lot of really fun... they all have a lot of really, really fun festivals here. Like, they have the Hummingbird Festival. Tooties! I used to ride my bike when I was a little bitty kid from Belle Plaine all the way on the back roads to Tooties just so I could go and get an ice cream float, man. Me and my five buddies used to ride our bikes all over the place. This is, you know, just a neat little town full of all kinds of history and historical, you know, preservation and beauty. And it's one of my favorite houses. It's the Sibley County Historical Museum. Isn't that neat? And then leaving town, you go right back up a giant frickin' hill and up and out of the valley. Yeah, it's a pretty neat, always like this hill because it's so twisty and curvy. And everybody out here in the country waves to you. So when you're driving by somebody, stick your fingers up over the windshield and give them a little wave. You know? I had some wash out there. Yeah, it's definitely a very large hill. Just like the one coming down into it. You know, it's beautiful. And then there's a couple of... There's a buddy I want to go and see one of these days here that he's just got the most beautiful river valley view, you know, out and about over the river that I have ever seen, you know, around the area, around Jordan area. And he lives in Jordan there. We've actually passed his driveway and his house coming into Jordan. He lives up on that bluff like I was talking about. And then I was pointing it to the camera out the window and said, this bluff, I really like this bluff. He lives up on top of that bluff right before Jordan. And it's a great big, I mean, it's a great big, huge driveway bluff. It's monstrous. This is another farm I always just thought was beautiful. I always thought it would have been really nice to grow up and be able to hang out around here. You know, but I never hung out around here. Although I did ride my bike in this area and did do a lot of hunting and hiking in the woods around here. Other people's property. When I was a little kid, I used to go hiking everywhere. But yeah, it's something else as far as beautiful goes. You couldn't ask for a more beautiful place to live. I mean, really, it's gorgeous. Look at these views. Look at that view out there, man. Tell me that ain't one hell of a view. Nice farms, beauty. Oh, and it's starting to pee. Starting to get rainy. Tell me that ain't beautiful scenery out there, you know? That guy has a yard full of junk. I've never seen more frickin' garbage and junk in someone's yard than in this forest right here, this little patch of land. His land is just caked with junk and garbage. It's unfrickin' believable. Another thing you'll notice about the country is, well, everybody drives slower than molasses, you know. Oh, and by the way, in case you didn't notice what these were, you see all them big rolls out there of tubing and all these big rolls of tubing here? Well, it's called corrugated tubing and variegated tubing for laying it down into the fields so that the fields can get drainage and they can hold moisture and retain water. But I used to work for a place a long time ago named Hancor that made that stuff down in Fairmont, Minnesota. And it wasn't bad work. It was hot work because you were hanging out around giant extruders, pumping out big old tubes of plastic, and then you had to roll them up on giant reels and then roll them out to the front door and a big old truck would come pick them up, fork truck, and it was definitely an interesting job. Doing, honey? Hey, it's Dad. Yeah, I'm almost there. I'm just outside of Gaylord here. I should be there in a few minutes. All right. Yeah, this is pretty neat out here. I mean, look at this view. Can't tell me that ain't a gorgeous view. Just huge and beautiful. I mean, yeah, there's lots of farmland out here, but it's definitely beautiful farmland. I mean, what I wouldn't give to have a nice big old acreage like that and go out and plant a farm. Hell, I'd grow hemp. That's what I would do. I'd grow one of these giant fields full of hemp. That's what I would do. Oh man, hemp is the most useful frickin' thing there is on earth. It'd be made into over 14,000 different useful products. And I like how some of these places you get out here and it's out into the country and you find these churches in the middle of frickin' nowhere. Oh, can't miss it, folks, here. Right here, just so you know. Another graveyard, ooh. I mean, they're frickin' everywhere. Minnesota just plants their people in the ground wherever, man. They don't care, they'll pick a spot. Once there's one or two graves there, wham, you'll see a whole mess of them. There's an old church, some Zionist-style Christian so-called church or whatnot, a something or other. They got a bunch of goofy different churches and branches of religion. See, that's one of the things out here is that you could just bounce from church to church around here. And every one of them is going to be wholly different. They're going to teach something different. They're not going to be teaching a set standard in the Bible. They're either, you know, and that's another thing with Minnesota is that I've noticed that, you know, as far as religion goes, there's just a mass amount of confused Christians who live in this state. You know, and it's not, I'm not nothing against Christianity, man, but seriously, why do we gotta have Catholics, Lutherans, Pentecostals, Protestants, Puritans, Zionists, we got evangelicals, we've got free activist Christian churches. We've got, I mean, just an ungodly mess of confused Christians that all seem to think that, you know, their church and their Bible and their way is the right way. Well, you're all claiming to be Christian, but you don't want to come together. You want to separate yourselves and call yourselves better in one way, shape, or form. Which just bewilders the living shit out of me, because I don't find it pertinent or even relevant to do that kind of stuff, to segregate yourself. Because, you know, if you're supposed to be Christian, you're supposed to be come together and work together and preach and work together. But since the society is so, it's so diverse, they, you know, people, the church has just started pandering to people's emotional needs and, oh, or emotional, you know, complaints. And so they had to change to this type of church and to that type of church and this type of evangelical and that type of Christian or that type of Lutheran or that type of, who cares, you know? I mean, that just blew me away how crazy it is all the way around the state as far as Christians, you know? They're all, each one of them will tell you they're right and you're going to hell if you don't believe in Jesus, but they want to segregate themselves from the entire group of Christians because, oh, the rest of them are just wrong. Looks a lot like one of my buildings. Yeah, Gaylord, that's always been a really pretty, I always like that right there. Always like that farm. It's always been a really pretty chunk of scenery when you're driving by. Anyway. Sorry about the rant, folks. We're coming up on Gaylord here pretty quick. And Gaylord, here's another small little town about the size of, well, it's a little smaller than Belle Plaine, Minnesota, but it's about the size of Jordan. They're about the same size. I always like them shots where it's just one or two lone trees out in the field. One tree says to the other tree, "Man, don't leave me. Don't leave me out here, man." Couldn't take it all alone out here with just my leaves. Don't leave me, brother. Don't leave me. You know, some tree comedy. Yeah, you know, them oak trees, they just kind of pop up in patches all over the place around here. There's a whole big patch of oak trees. Another one way back there. Yeah, it's definitely neat. Definitely neat scenery out here, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. It's quite a good chunk, a 40-minute video or better. 40-minute trip. And I'll show you a little bit of Gaylord, and then have to kill the camera for a bit, and then we'll pick up my monkey, Zoe, and then we'll be on our way back here. I hope you enjoy this video. Oh, look, folks, look, off in the distance. You'll never guess what it is. Another graveyard! Another frickin' graveyard, folks. They just never give up around here, do they? They just like dying. And they like being seen after they die. Oh, man, we'll just put this graveyard on top of this hill out in the middle of the open nowhere so everyone sees it for about 2 miles. You know, because heaven forbid we got the, you know, the dead don't get any attention, you know. And some disgusting hog farms. and a organic beef farm here. And, yeah, this is, you know, pig farms are just horrible, man. During the summer, they freaking reek. And they reek, they don't just reek, they reek for miles. I mean, miles they reek. They freaking reek for miles. Stink worse than anything you could possibly stand smelling for more than 2 minutes. It'll make you gag. But, yeah, we're coming into Gaylord here, and like I said, she's not in a, not the most populated city in Minnesota, but it's definitely one of the most unique, and being as that its name is one of the most unique in Minnesota, you probably can't get any weirder than that. Gaylord, Minnesota, or how other people pronounce it, Gaylord, Minnesota. It's kind of a, I don't know, it's a country town. It's got a couple of few factories in it. And big ass trucking stop here. And that's where Mr. Grainbelt here is probably going to end up. Either that or at the feed mill in the middle of town. But anyway, yeah, that's kind of a little factory here. Not exactly sure. Can't remember what it is. Oh, it's the McHale Foods. Yeah, it's a big food facility where they make all the processed foods just for you, so that they'll, you know, you can eat. And they got an agri fleet. Yeah, that didn't sound too promising. I'm staying out from under him. Got the agri fleet here. And the miscellaneous. Couple of steel shops. County buildings. Here's another little factory. This is one control assemblies company. Do electronic parts and pieces for controls and machines. And then there's the Iverson Company. That's steel and component parts. And then there's a county, and there's a nice little bar and the bank and hotel and another factory. I think that's city and county. You know, an Articat, and it's a nice little thriving town. It really is. It's a nice town. I've always appreciated it, and you know, I wouldn't mind living here if I had to, minus the name. It kind of rubs me the wrong way. If you know what I mean. Being a straight guy, living in a town of Gaylord just kind of seems a little off. But anyway, this is Gaylord at its best. It's getting all tore up. Its streets all tore up right now. And some work done. And it is a nice little town. There's the Gaylord feed mill, and apparently he ain't going there. He's off somewhere else. Yeah, it's a nice little town. Got lots of nice little buildings, and it's laid out nice. It's not laid out all confusing, and it's got a nice atmosphere to the town. Lots of neat little buildings and Doobers. There's Jerry's Foods and the bar and a little strip mall and the church. Well, TV 0039 out for Gaylord, Minnesota. And the road trip.